Storyboard Pro comes equipped with 8 custom workspaces that are specifically tailored to suit the needs of storyboard artists working on different aspects of the storyboard. For example, the drawing workspace, which is the default workspace you see when you first launch Storyboard Pro, is best suited for those who need to draw in the software. Other workspaces include the timeline workspace, which is suited for creating animatics, the 3D workspace, which is suited to integrating 3D elements, and the overview workspace, which was designed so that you could see a general overview of your project in order to better rearrange the panels. And those are just to name a few. So there are at least 3 different ways that you can change your workspace in Storyboard Pro. As you noticed, I was clicking on a bunch of different buttons here at the top. So this is your view toolbar, and it houses the 8 custom workspaces that I mentioned. And if you hover over them, you can see the name of the workspace. So vertical workspace, pitch mode workspace, PDF view workspace, 3D view workspace, so you have an idea. The other way that you can change workspaces is by going to the Windows menu and selecting Workspace, Workspace, and then selecting from one of the 8 that you see in the list. So let's select PDF review, for example. The third way is by bringing up the Workspace toolbar, and you can do that by going to Windows, Toolbars, Workspace, and the Workspace toolbar appeared right here. So from this drop-down list, you also see those 8 custom workspaces. So let's go back to the drawing workspace. And another thing that's good to know is that if you add views, delete views, move views, and resize them, the software auto-saves these changes so that the next time you open this project, all the panels will be arranged and look just as they were when you closed it. Another thing you can do is create and save a custom workspace. And you can do this by going back to the Windows menu and selecting Workspace, Save Workspace As. And in the Save Workspace As dialog box, you can enter the name of your new workspace. So I'm going to call this one My Workspace and say OK. Then if we go back to the Windows menu under Workspace, Workspace, My Workspace appears in the workspace list. Then if you make changes to that workspace, you can save these changes by going to Windows, Workspace, Save Workspace. But in fact, even if you don't do this, the software will save these changes automatically. The other thing you can do is delete this workspace if you'd like to no longer see it from this list, or for example, if you've created too many custom workspaces and they're just cluttering up your list. And you can do that by launching the Workspace Manager. So you can do that either through this menu, we see it here at the top, Workspace Manager, or another way to do it is by bringing up the Workspace toolbar one more time. So now we see it here, and you can click on this icon here. So I'm not going to go into detail about the Workspace Manager, but I just want to let you know that on the left side, you can select the workspace that you'd like to delete. So in this case, it's My Workspace, and you can delete it by clicking on the minus icon, and then you can click Apply to validate your change, and then click OK to close the window. So now when you close your project and you relaunch the software, it'll go back to the drawing workspace as a default mode. The last thing you can do is restore your default workspace. So once again, if you did too many funky adjustments to your workspace like you see here, and you just want it to look like it did when you were in a certain view, then you can go to the top menu and select Windows, Restore Default Workspace. And in this particular case, it takes me back to the drawing workspace because it doubles as the default workspace and I was previously in my custom workspace, which I deleted. However, if you rearranged one of the other default workspaces, such as the 3D workspace, by selecting Restore Default Workspace, it should take you back to the way that the 3D workspace originally looked.